Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all are having a great day. So before I start with today's video, I just wanted to justify my absence from YouTube since my first video. Recently I got an opportunity to showcase my art and craft stuff at a college fest, and I also got opportunity to conduct few workshops. What you see on screen are all the snippets from the successful workshop conducted. So let's begin with today's video. Today's video is all about the basics of paper cutting, that is the materials that you need to start doing a paper cutting art. Some of these materials are cutting mat, a paper cutting knife, templates or the designs on which you do the paper cutting, and finally, once you have done the paper cut, how to store them. The first item in the list is a paper cutting mat. It serves as a base on which you put the paper and do the paper cutting. This mat is made of PVC material and it is self-healing. That means that if you cut with knife, it will not show any cuts and creases on the mat. These cutting mats come in different shapes, sizes and colors, and some of them are even translucent or transparent in nature. The starting price for these mats is Rs. 300 only, and the price increases as you increase the size of the mat. You can find these mats in the local craft store, or you can also place an order for them online on websites like AliExpress. The larger mats are a little expensive, so if you are a beginner in the paper cutting art, it is recommended that you start with the A4 cutting mat and gain some experience in paper cutting. Once you are more comfortable with the paper cutting, then you can go for the larger mats like the A3 or A2 or A1 size cutting mats. The next cutting mat I have is the A3 size cutting mat. This is one of my most used cutting mats because I can easily cut A4 designs and A3 designs on this cutting mat. The only difference between the A3 and the A4 cutting mat is that of size. Both are made of the same PVC material and both are self-healing in nature. If you are working on an A4 design which you need to rotate frequently, then it is recommended that you use the A3 cutting mat because it will keep the paper entirely on the mat during the paper cutting. And lastly, the A2 size cutting mat, which is the largest cutting mat that I have. It is perfectly suited for my A3 and A4 designs as it allows me to rotate the paper seamlessly without any interruption in the paper cutting. The next important thing you need is a paper cutting knife. There are a lot of knives available in the market which you can use to do the paper cutting, but the most common blade paper cutters use is the A11 knife. The spare blades for this knife is easily available in the market, and hence it's a very popular among the paper cutters. To change the blade, you need to gently unscrew the top portion of the knife and the blade will become loose and you can pull it out. To put the blade back in, while the knife is unscrewed, you need to insert the blade again into the knife and then screw the top back again to tighten the blade. With each paper cutting knife, you get few spare blades, and these are the spare blades I got with this knife. The next knife I have is this slender yellow knife with a longer grip as compared to the previous knife. These are the spare blades that I got with this knife. These blades are much shorter in length than the A11 blades, and they are also smaller in width. To put the blade into the knife, you need to unscrew the top gently and insert the blade once the slot for the blade opens. And after you have inserted the blade, you need to screw the top back again so that you can tighten the blade. For a seasoned paper cutter, it does not matter which size of blade they are using for doing the paper cutting. But if you are a beginner in the paper art, you can go with the smaller knives as it allows to do intricate paper cuts more easily. The next knife I have is called the pen knife. It is called so because it resembles a pen or a pencil. And to make the knife operational, you need to push the button at the top of the pen knife and it will bring the blade out at the bottom of the knife. One of the biggest advantages of this knife is that it has the grip of a pen or a pencil, and we all are used to the pen or pencil grip, so it's very easy to hold this knife and do the paper cutting. Also, the knife of this blade is very fragile and very thin, and it is suited for extremely intricate paper cuts. The removal and insertion of blade is a little tricky with this knife. To remove the blade, you need to push the button a little more further, and this will open the slot for the blade at the bottom. Once the slot is open, you remove the blade, and if you want to insert the blade, while the slot is still open, you need to put the blade in and then let go of the button at the top. To close this knife, you need to push this button and the blade will go inside. The next knife I have is this blue knife, which is similar to the yellow knife I have shown earlier. In terms of the differences between the two knives, you can see that the grip of the blue knife is smaller than the grip of the yellow knife. Also, the yellow knife is much more steadier than the blue knife. Well, both the knives use almost similar kind of blades. The blue knife is basically a cheaper version of the yellow knife. Also, the grip on the blue knife is a little rougher than the knives we have seen so far. So if you are engaged in long sessions of paper cutting, then it might cause discomfort to your fingers. The last knife I have is a little unique in design because it goes on your finger like shown in the video and you don't hold it like the rest of the knives we have seen so far. This knife uses variety of blades like the A11 blade, or it can also use some smaller blades. I'm not really comfortable using this knife because it puts a lot of pressure on my finger, but this knife can be easily used for doing the clay work. I feel you really need to get used to the design of this knife to be able to do paper cutting on a regular basis with this knife. Now that we have seen the different kind of knives and the paper cutting mats that are used for the paper cutting, I'm summarizing all the materials discussed so far in one single frame. Please note that none of the knife is useless, or you know, one knife is better than the other knife. Each knife has its own kind of purpose for paper cutting. Some are used for broad paper cuts and some are used for intricate paper cuts. Similarly, each mat has its own uses. If you are working only on small paper cuts, there is no need to buy a bigger mat. But if you are working on bigger paper cuts, you will definitely need a larger mat. Also, if during the paper cutting you accidentally overcut a paper cut, then in that case, you can use the transparent glue to stick the parts together back again. As a last component to paper cutting art, you will need a template or a design on which you will do the paper cutting. There are a lot of digital assets available online through which you can make your own design, or you can freely download credit-free designs from websites like Pixabay. You can also design your own templates, or you can collaborate with artists. If you are using design from someone else, it is always good that you credit the designer. The only thing left to discuss in this video is now how to store the designs that you have created by doing paper cutting. One of the ways is to use a document folder like one shown in the video, wherein you can put the paper cut that you have created on top of another paper and insert it into the leaves. The other way to store the paper cut is to frame it and then put the frames in storage. And that's it for today's video. I hope you guys like this video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you all on my next video.